This is the application for the Tapo color LED. Here we can see in the Tapo application on my homepage, I have a quick access panel to the LED. I could turn it on or off, and it's located just to the right of the camera, so you'll see that turn on and off and change color as we go through the review. If I select into it, that's going to bring me into the actual settings and controls for the light. Here we could see we have an adjustable image for it. We have the name and its location, and then a quick toggle for the power. You can see there's a subtle animation that happens on the screen itself when you power it on and off. As we come down, we have our presets. So here you can have individual preset colors. I've got a couple, as I will cycle through them right there. You could see if I leave it on this purple, you also have the ability to adjust the brightness right from there. We have this A, which is auto mode, which will allow you to automatically compensate and adjust the color temperature for the lack of natural light to ensure that you always have sufficient illumination. This is ideal for outdoor use, but this is an indoor bulb. We have auto match, which will set the color and temperature and brightness based on sunrise and sunset. If we want to add another color to our presets, we select our edit icon, and then we could select any one of these to make a change. So if I have these two purples, I can come in here, I could change the color. Notice we could also have a preset for the brightness and then select save. We could also reorder simply by selecting and then dragging and dropping where we want. We'll leave it at done and then select back. And now if I select my purple, there's my 100% one and there is my 50%. If we come down to our white or color selection, here we could change the color temperature of a white light, and you can see the Kelvin level right there. If I change this to color, it's going to bring up kind of like a color palette, and we can select what we want. You can see the color changing over there to the right, but you also have this little square letting you know exactly the color that you happen to be on. And you could just drag, and notice if you give it a second, it will change the color. We're going to come back to our white and select my bright white. Notice you don't just change when you select white or color. You actually have to click on something in order for it to make that change. If we come down, here we have our energy use. It's going to show you the runtime for today, energy usage, and then energy saved. This is not actually in real time because if I use my little button here and we turn it off, that doesn't change. That's not changing because it's energy used throughout the day, not this exact second. And then you have past 7 days and 30 days. This particular LED light hasn't been on. The other one I thought I grabbed has been on longer, but that's where that data is. Coming down, we have theming. So you've got party. I could play that. And now it's changing based on a party. I can also change. Now it's a little more relaxed. We'll pause that. We can edit any one of these themes where we can edit the name, the shift style. So you've got breathing or bold, speed, how quickly we want the changes to happen, and then colors to cycle through, and then brightness setting. That's under our theme. We have our schedule. This will allow us to set up a schedule for during these times or sunrise and sunset, turn on the LED or turn off the LED or fade in and fade out. And then you have your light setting and then days. Keep in mind, if you set up a schedule to turn the light on and you're not going to actively be home, you're going to want to make sure you set up a schedule to turn that off as well. Coming down to timer, this will be how long the device is off for. When the 5 minute timer ends, the device will turn off. Likewise, if I set turn on in 5 minutes of inactivity, it will then turn itself on. Away mode will turn the LED light bulb on and off at random intervals, making it nearer somebody is in the house. You could set up a start time and an end time, and then individual days of the week if you only want to have it during specific times. And then we have our smart actions. Preparing for sleep is one that's on by default. And what this will do is kind of start dimming everything in the house to make it easier for you to get to sleep. We can share the device from here. Somebody will need their own Tapo account. We have support center and then add this to favorites, on or off. If we come to the top of the page here and select our settings, this will allow us to change the device icon, change the device name, change its location, change the default status. This is an important one. When turning on from the application, it will be in its last on state, or we could select customize and we could set up a color and temperature that we want it to be at. If we leave it at last on, if we had it at red at 100%, that's what it'll come back as. And then this is very important. When power is cut off and returned, how does the device come back? By default, it's on turn on. So when power is restored, whether the device was on or off, it will come back in an on state. If we have this one selected, the device will come back in whatever state it was in. If it was off, it'll come back in an off state. And if it was on, it will come back in an on state. Recommend making that change right away. Here we have lights off gradually. So you can select gradually on and gradually off, and then select a duration. So instead of instant on, instant off, you could say, how long do I want this to warm up for? So in my case, we will set this for 5 seconds and then select done. And then if I use my little button here and we turn it on, instead of turning on right away, you can see it's gradually turning on. And we will do that again to give you an idea. Gradually turning on. And now it's at 100%. If I turn that off, this is the difference, right to on. That is a very useful feature, especially if you're using these light bulbs in a bedroom situation. You have groups where you can group several items together. If you have multiple light bulbs, you can group them all together to create a single action that you can have. And then we have our smart actions, which I showed you before, device info, information about the device, and then firmware update. If you need to update the firmware manually, that's where you can come and do it. And that is everything that we can do for the Tapo LED color changing smart light bulb in the Tapo app. As you saw,